God damn it, Poro, I hate you so freaking much right now. For those who don't know, Poro is a hentai company that I had praised in my second episode for the drastic improvement in the quality of their hentai over the past year. While Poro's resume does include some of the most infuriatingly horrible hentai out there, including I Can, which was bad enough to be my first review, their recent lineup has included some really amazing ones, like Bloods, Floating Material, and even Lucky Draw Triangle, one of my top 10 favorites. But apparently, Poro has watched the video where I acknowledged this, and said, hey, you know what? He's right. Our hentai haven't been shitty enough recently. And went out of their way to make their next release the most horrifically vile piece of crap humanity has ever produced. This is Kowaku no Toki. In English, Time of the Rapture. Now, I'm not going to show you the cover for the DVD, because if I did, I'd have to censor almost half of it. Which would kind of defeat the purpose. Now, normally I'd wait till the second episode came out before I reviewed it, but this series is so horrible it deserves to get bashed right from the get-go. Well, let's dive right in and get it over with, because I don't want to develop high blood pressure from raging at how horrible this is too long. Okay, so we open with a dungeon S&M scene so depraved and disgusting that even the most hardcore fans of this genre will want to vomit their own intestines. And yes, this is a still image you're watching right now, because if I showed any more of it, not only would it get blocked from YouTube in an instant, but anyone who watched it would develop a brain tumor from the imagery. The most I can describe to you is that a girl is having large objects inserted into her by demons, causing her stomach to distort in such a way that a real person would have been ripped in half. Yes, this is actually what we're starting on. I think the audience is already praying for the real Rapture to come and save them. So anyway, after the audience either passes out, turns the DVD off, or somehow makes it through that scene, we see that the whole scene is just a dream in the head of a main character who clearly needs psychiatric help if he's dreaming shit like that. He comes across some kind of weird demon and runs for his life. And in a cliche that's been used in God knows how many 40s horror movies, comes across an old mansion in the middle of a forest. And in a mysterious twist, comes across a schoolgirl who looks exactly like the one he saw in his dream. Oh yeah, this hentai has a plot. I think. So the girl tells our main character to get lost, but he persists on asking for directions. Her mother arrives to invite him inside, and, being a total dipshit, doesn't question why this grand mansion has no phone service. The mother says he can stay the night if he has nowhere to go. Yes, a hentai is actually ripping off Dracula. So the guy goes upstairs and crashes for the night, and then we're greeted to the most horrific, disgustingly revolting torture scene I have ever seen in anything ever. I can't believe I actually have to explain this to someone, but if you're watching this, Poro, childbirth isn't sexy! No, I am not even kidding you. The very next scene after he falls asleep is the girl giving birth in an erotic torture chamber. I cannot express in words how infuriated I am to live on a planet where this could get published on DVD. So after that, we get a scene where the girl's mother comes into the guy's room to have sex with him. Which, to be fair, is probably the only erotic scene in the whole show. But after what they just saw, I don't think anyone cares anymore. Let's talk about my favorite scene in the whole episode. Toward the end of the episode, the guy meets the girl by the river and confesses to her about his dreams, and how he's worried that they may be real. The girl confirms that yes, this is true, and the guy says he wants to save her. But she wants him to just go away and not risk his life over her. So, in other words, the hentai that tried to turn us on with some of the most horrific imagery since the Holocaust is now trying to have an emotional development, which pulls at your heartstrings. Where do I even begin with this? To begin with, hentai has no business trying to have emotional development ever. The whole idea of hentai is to pull at your pants, not your heart. You can't have it both ways, and when you try to, both parts distract from each other and the whole series becomes a broken down mess. But even if that wasn't the case, we just saw this girl in several erotic torture scenes. And now we're supposed to feel sorry for her? Are you actually trying to make us feel guilty by being turned on by your own hentai? Well, thank God it's over after that scene, because this is absolutely the worst thing I have ever seen in my life, by far. Time of the Rapture has all the same problems as Poro's earlier anime, multiplied several times over. Guys simply don't get turned on when they're hating characters and plot elements. And the quote-unquote erotic scenes are so horrific that even sadists wouldn't get turned on by them. I hate this hentai, I hope it burns in hell along with the creators, and no one ever should have to see it. I'm gonna go get some ice water.